Hello, I'm Barbara Davis. I live in East Alstead, and I have been a potter. Well, I got started in high school, and it is what I have a degree in from college. So that's a good long time. This summer at the mill, I am going to be teaching a tile making workshop. The reason I started making tiles was because I needed tiles for the house I was building. And so that was big motivating factor and inspiration to me. And in Italy, there are tiles everywhere. Like there are just entire benches made of tiles and tiles on the floor, tiles on the wall, tiles on the ceiling, and mosaics everywhere. And that was pretty inspiring too. And it's really very simple to make a tile. They're all going to be handmade. They're all going to be individual, and they're going to be beautiful, I have a feeling. And I got this great idea a few years ago for making them more consistent. And so I had a friend that just took, I just had a piece of plywood and they cut out squares in this long piece of plywood. And so you'll simply push your hands down with the into the clay into each square. And then basically you just push it in really pretty hard so that you make sure that the bottom part is all smooth. And yeah, and then we'll cut it off. And you can make five at a time with that form. Not that everyone's going to be making five at a time, but you'll be able to make several tiles in the workshop. So you can see how each tile similar in shape and color, the background, but depending on what you put on it and how you decorate it, I have lots of things to press in. You know, you can see I've got trees and I've got flowers and I've got all kinds of things. Say if there's a goldenrod plant, you can pick the goldenrod and then you can push that into the clay, and that makes a really lovely relief that way. So we can use the plants that are around, like a pine tree bough makes a really nice rest in image. We will add color to the tiles. I have some underglaze colors, which you apply to the clay when it's before you fire it. So then when they're fired, they'll already have their color on them. So I will do the second part, which is just simply to put the clear glaze over the top of them. When you fire clay the first time, it isn't always the true color of the clay. And it's not until it's fired the second time and has a clear glaze over it does it bring out the true color of the clay. So this clay is tan, but it has these beautiful, really small little brown iron specks in it. And I think it's really nice.